Now, we've talked a lot about Azure SQL, but once you get to Azure SQL, there are a lot of other opportunities in the cloud. As you can see, there are a lot of other services once you're in Azure that you can start to leverage and integrate to build really interesting, really powerful, intelligent solutions and applications for things like IoT or streaming or automation or all sorts of things.
You know, Anna, this is an interesting slide we put together because, first of all, look at the bottom of this thing. Just remember that even if you're migrating from SQL Server to Azure SQL, there's still opportunities for hybrid scenarios to connect your SQL to Azure SQL. But once you're in the cloud, I mean, look at all these icons. They all represent things that would take a great deal of effort for you to build in your data center and support across your organization. That would be amazing, right? But because you're in Azure, we at Microsoft have built these solutions. Even our partners have built solutions. And any one of these things are all about data or processing of data, right? So they all tie in to a data store like Azure SQL. So, you know, and I'm looking at this thing here in my head and I'm like, okay, there's a lot of icons, but is there an example of how you might actually connect a solution together?
Yeah, definitely, Bob. And I think that's a great question, a great call out. Throughout the Microsoft sort of documentation, they have a whole section dedicated to Azure architectures. And I just went through and there's a bunch there, but I pulled one that I thought was pretty interesting around IoT.
Yeah, Anna, this helps me because I was trying to figure out like, how would I put IoT and streaming and logic and machine learning and connect it actually to Azure? And I see the example here. This is literally like, if you really had an IoT solution with devices on the edge and you wanted to feed data in a streaming way, but then maybe store results of that into an Azure database or store raw type of data into Azure Blob storage and then run machine learning models on it and make sure you have Azure Directory and Power BI. I mean, it kind of makes sense to me now how you might connect some things. This is very helpful. And I think there's a lot of examples out there, but Anna, I'm a developer at heart. Like, is there any code to this thing that I can look at?
Yeah, that's a great question. And, you know, something we hear a lot and something we're continuing to, you know, kind of put out new solutions and new code for. For this architecture specifically, like I mentioned, it's part of the Azure Architecture Center guides. And this one is for IoT. And you see the same architecture diagram here. And wonderfully, down at the bottom, there is a GitHub repository, which you can actually go and kind of get the code for and even get information on how you would go about setting this up. So we've talked a lot about Azure SQL, and now in this video, you've seen some of the options and capabilities and solutions that might be available to you in the cloud and how you can go bigger with things like Azure SQL and even for scenarios like IoT, and there are many other scenarios out there. We'll see you in the next video.